So, hello everyone. In this part, we will talk about crystal field theory, and it's basically a new theory which is to overcome our valence bond theory, okay, the limitations of VBT. So, here we will see crystal field theory. So, before going into detail, let's see. Crystal field theory, CFT, is an electrostatic model, okay. So, it consists of point charges, okay, we will see that. So, here we consider the metal and ligand bond to be ionic. It arises purely due to electrostatic forces of interaction or electrostatic forces, okay, between the metal ion and the ligand. The ligand are treated as point charges, okay, either they will be neutral or they will be negatively charged in case of anions, and they will be treated as dipoles in case of neutral molecules. Now, note that the 5d orbitals in an isolated gaseous metal atom, okay, they have the same energy. Okay, if they have the same energy, we call them degenerate. Okay, so now this degeneracy is maintained if a spherical symmetrical field of negative charges surround the metal / ion. Okay, only in that case it can be maintained. Now, however, when this field is due to ligand in a complex, so if the ligands are approaching our metal ion, it becomes asymmetrical. Okay, the field becomes asymmetrical, and hence the degeneracy of the d orbital is lifted, okay, resulting in splitting of our d orbital. So the pattern of the splitting depends on the nature of the crystal field which has been created by the incoming ligand. Okay, so let's look how the d orbitals are. So if you remember, in 11th standard we have studied that these are the structures of d orbitals. You can see here, this is your dx square minus y square, dz square. If you see, they are the ones which are pointing towards the axis. Okay, whereas dxy, dyz, dxz, they are in xy plane, yz plane and xz plane respectively. Now, in an octahedral coordination entity, that is when we talk about coordination number 6, okay, with 6 ligands, okay, so the surrounding metal atom or ion, okay, there will be repulsion between the electrons in the metal d orbitals and electrons or the negative charges of the ligand. Okay, so there will be a repulsion. Now here we are talking only about octahedral, okay, that is coordination number is 6. Now such a repulsion will be more when the metal d orbital are directed towards the ligand. Okay, so in octahedral geometry, the ligand might approach from the axis, that is along z axis, y axis or xy or z axis. In that case, the repulsion will be more. If repulsion is more, meaning dx square minus y square and d square orbitals, they will point towards the axis, that is along the direction of ligand, and they will experience much more repulsion. Hence, the energy will be raised. Okay. Whereas dxy, yz and xz, they are directed between the axis, they are on the plane. Okay. And hence, they will actually having lower energy. Okay. So, will be lowered in energy relative to the average energy in spherical crystal field. So these three are going to stay at lower energy as the ligand is not approaching along their side, whereas in case of these two orbital, they will be raised up in energy. Now, so thus the degeneracy of the d orbital has been removed. Okay, so they are not of same energy level. So you can see this diagram here, you can see y-axis represents energy. So originally all of them, the d orbitals were at the same energy level. Now, whenever the ligand is coming closer, okay, so it goes to an excited state, which is here, and then this is your new excited state, this new field, and then it splits as the ligand approaches. Okay, so as the ligand approaches, you see that there is a T2G level and there is EG level. You can see it here. This is T2G, EG level. So that is how the splitting occurs. So T2G level contains three orbitals. You can see this is dxy, dxz, dyz, whereas dx square minus y square, dz square orbital, they go higher up in energy. That stays as EG stage, okay, or EG set, you can call it. And the difference between the energy is known as delta O. O here represents octahedral splitting, okay, because we are talking about octahedral splitting. So and in this octahedral complex, to yield three orbitals of lower energy, that is T2g set, okay, and two orbitals of higher energy, that is Eg set. Okay, now also note that the splitting is such that the energy that has increased up of Eg, same is the energy which is decreased in T2g level. Meaning, if you add the energies of Eg and energies of T2g, you will get this energy level. Okay, that is the average. Okay, so this splitting of the degenerate levels due to the presence of ligand in definite geometry is termed as crystal field splitting, and the energy of separation is denoted by delta subscript O. O stands for octahedral splitting. Later we will see tetrahedral splitting also. Now, thus the energy of the two Eg orbitals will be raised by 3 by 5 delta O, and that of 3 T2g will be decreased by 2 by 5 delta O. Okay, if you multiply this into 3, you will get 6 by 5 delta O, that is with a negative sign since it has decreased. And if you multiply this, that is energy increase of Eg level, by 2, because there are only 2 orbitals where the energy has increased. So you will see, you will again get 6 by 5 delta O. Okay, that is energy increased. If you add the 2, you will see it is 0. Okay, because this is negative decrease in energy and this is increase in energy. So that's how it splits. One goes lower in energy, T2g set, and Eg set goes higher in energy. Now, the crystal field splitting delta O, it depends upon the field produced by the ligand and the charge on the metal ion. Okay, so it depends on the two factor. One is the field which is produced by the ligand, and the other is metal ion. Okay, so this is what happens. Now, talking about the ligands, okay, so some ligands, they produce strong fields, so meaning the splitting will be large. Okay, that means the value of delta O, okay, value of delta O will be large if you have strong field ligands, and whereas the others produce weak fields, so consequently what will happen, the splitting of the d orbital will be smaller. Okay, so you can actually generate a spectrochemical series. You can see this is your spectrochemical series. So this series is experimentally determined, okay, and it is based on absorption of light by complexes with different ligands. Okay, so if you want, you can note down the series. Now, in order to come to electronic configuration, okay, let's talk about electronic configuration in d orbital. So let's say that this is the splitting. Okay, this is T2g level, this is Eg level. So for 3 electrons, if we talk about only 3 electrons, the 3 electrons will come at T2g level, one electron, another, and another. Okay, now the 4th electron creates a confusion. The 4th electron can pair with T2g, okay, or it can go to Eg. Okay, so therefore d4 ions, let's say if it is the d4 ion, two possible patterns of electron distribution can arise. Okay, the 4th electron could either enter the T2g level, okay, that is the same level, it can pair, or it can go to higher energy level, that is Eg level, okay, that is this level here. So which of these possibilities occur, it depends on relative magnitude of crystal field splitting, that is delta naught value, and pairing energy. Pairing energy is denoted by P, that is the energy required for an electron pairing in a single orbital. Okay, so that will be your pairing energy. So if your pairing energy is more than splitting, okay, more than delta naught, then you will have the electronic configuration T2g3eg1. Okay, so I repeat, if pairing energy is more, so it will not pair, it in fact it will go up in Eg level. So the electronic configuration will become T2g3eg1. So ligands are known, in this case ligands are known as weak field ligands, and they form high spin complexes. Okay, because pairing energy is more, okay, it requires more amount of energy to pair. Whereas if the splitting is large, okay, if the splitting is large, delta O naught value is large, that means you have a strong field ligand, then you will see that the 4th electron will pair with this T2g. So this will give you electronic configuration of T2G4EG0, okay, and it will form low spin complex as electrons are getting paired up, okay. Calculations show that D4 to D7 coordination entities are more stable for strong field as compared to weak field cases. Okay, so this is an experimental data. So just note down this, very very important. So that answers how the strong field and weak field ligands are different. It depends on the splitting energy and it depends on your pairing energy P. The next thing is crystal field splitting in tetrahedral coordination entity. So here also we have our energy level on the y-axis. You can see the d orbitals of free ion. Okay, then the average energy of the d orbital in spherical crystal field, it increases its energy, and then the splitting occurs. Now when we talk about tetrahedral, the ligands does not approach through the six axis, that is x, y and z axis. They approach along the other planes. Okay, so in that case you see that dx square minus y square and dz square, since they are along the axis, they do not experience repulsion. Hence they get decrease in their energy, whereas dxy, dyz, dxz, they are along the plane, hence their energy is increased. So you can see EG level having lower energy and T2G level is having higher energy, and splitting is the gap between the energy, or the degeneracy is denoted by delta T. T here stands for tetrahedral. So in tetrahedral coordination entity formation, the d orbital splitting is inverted, as is smaller as compared to octahedral field splitting. For the same metal and same ligands, the metal ligand distances, it can be shown that delta T is 4 by 9 delta naught. So if you see, tetrahedral splitting is lower. So consequently, the orbital splitting energies are not sufficient, not sufficiently large for forcing pairing, and therefore low spin configuration are rarely observed. Okay, so this is the main reason. Okay, so orbital splitting energies are not sufficiently large for forcing pairing. Okay, hence you will see always low spin configuration will be not absorbed in this particular case. Okay, and that's it. Thank you.